Hi everybody, my name is Esther, and today I'm going to introduce you a software called Aegisub. This is a very short tutorial of how to use Aegisub to subtitle your video. Okay, now let's first have a look at our outline. Today I'm going to cover how to download this app, how to operate it, how to save the file, and in the end we will watch what we have done. Okay, let's ready? The first step is download the software. Whenever you use the software, the first thing you need is to download it, right? So it's very easy. You can directly go to www.aegisub.org. This is the website of Aegisub, and at its front page, it writes, Aegisub is a free cross-platform open source tool for creating and modifying subtitles. And this is also the reason why I'm recommending this software to you. And then you click download, and you can find it provides different versions for different platforms. If you are a Mac or Windows, you can find the suitable version in this here. So you don't have to worry about whether this software work or not on your platform. So click full install, and then it will install install the software on your computer, and the first step is done. It's really easy, right? Okay, now since this only very short tutorial, it's only about 10 minutes. So I'm going to teach you the very basic function of this software to get you started. And once you know the basic function, then you can explore it yourself and you will realize how efficient and easy to use this software. Okay. The second step is the actual operation. This is hard for me to do a live mock in class, and I'm afraid of there might be some problem with my computer. So I made two short videos on my computer ahead of time. And it's much clearer and easier to follow me if I'm videotape my instruction. Okay, now in the first video, I'm going to introduce you how to prepare for subtitling, then how to type in the script, and how to adjust the timing.
Okay, so after you download the Aegisub, now we can start our actual operation. Okay, the first thing you need to do is to choose the file that you want to translate. Click video and open video. And I'm going to translate it. La La Land. And this is a trailer, and I downloaded it from YouTube. Okay, now the video is here. And this same thing here is called the soundtrack. This is the sound of this video, and if you only open the video file, then sometimes the computer might lose its sound. So after you open your video file, you also need to add audio. Okay, from here, you click audio and click open audio from video. Okay. And now our preparation is done. And since the source text has no subtitles and it is an English version, so the first thing that we need to do is to type the script. How are you going to do it? This is the selecting area, and first you need to play it. Click play.
I don't know why I keep moving my body.
This
the best movie ever.
This blue line here is the end of this selecting area, and this is the starting point. So You can adjust it according to how long you want to type.
I don't know why I keep moving my body.
This is where you type in your text. After you write it, click Shift and Enter to save it. To save this line. You click save.
I don't know why I keep moving my body.
The first line is done. Now click enter to have our next line. And then
the best movie of 2016.
Just repeat what you have done before.
Okay, now this is the first three step, and then in the second video, I'm going to introduce you how to check typo mistakes and then check the visual display.
After we type in all the script, we're going to check the mistakes in it. The first thing you can see here are two red lines. When something's red, it really means there are mistakes in it. So let's zoom in to make it bigger. You can also see from here, the second line shows even before the first line. So, and the ending time of the second line is behind the starting time of the second line. So there is a confliction in timing. So what we're going to do is select the two lines and click Make times continuous. You can either change the start of time or the end of the time. In this case, we're going to change the end time of the first line. Now it's fixed. And there's no mistakes in typo. So after checking typo mistakes, we're going to check the V-roll. So to check if the V-roll works well. So first, we're going to zoom in the video. And play
the best movie of 2016.
And you can see here, the font and the size of the subtitle is too small, so it's hard to read for, especially for old people or short-sighted people. So we're going to go back and change the font. Here, you can see here, it's edit. Click edit, and now we can change the font we like and also the size of the subtitle. Let's make it 40. Okay. Now let's check it again.
This okay. Is about the view.
Now it works well.
Okay, so we have finished editing and checking. Now the next step is saving the file. It's really easy. You just need to click save and name your file and then click save it. But after you save this file, the form of the subtitle is ASS, and then you need to put the subtitle file and the original MP4 video file in under one portfolio. Then it can show together. And if you your computer is Windows, then you don't have to download any other player. You can directly click you can directly play this video, and then the subtitle will automatically appears on the screen. But if you are a Mac, then you need an additional sync name simplist. And if you're a Mac, then you need an additional step for Mac. You go to this is a software that I found is free, and it's really small, and it's also works. So I also recommend this if you're using Mac. Okay, so the last step is this is my reference, and the last step is let's actually watch what we have made. Okay. You just directly drag the file in the software, and then the subtitle will automatically show. Okay.
16. This is about the future.
Really?
Yes. I don't know. He's now the winner of 7 Golden Globe Awards, including Best Picture of the Year. It's conflict and it's compromise. It's very, very exciting. We can start a fire.
Rated PG-13. Now playing everywhere. Okay, that's the end of my presentation, and this is my references. Thank you for watching.